Hi, and welcome to PhysioTutors. My name is Andreas, and in today's video, I would like to give you a more in-depth view into one of the most frequently described pathological shoulder conditions in general practice, which is the shoulder impingement. Shoulder impingement used to be described as being a diagnosis, but the view on the condition has shifted towards considering it to be a cluster of symptoms rather than a pathology itself. Various studies have identified underlying pathological mechanisms like rotator cuff pathology, scapular dyskinesis, shoulder instability, biceps pathology, slap lesions, and glenohumeral internal rotation deficit, which is abbreviated as GIRD. These conditions are suggested to cause impingement symptoms. The literature describes two types of impingement, subacromial or external impingement, and internal impingement. Subacromial impingement is the mechanical encroachment of soft tissue structures like bursa or rotator cuff tendons in the subacromial space between the humeral head and the acromial arch. Patients often present pain in the mid-range of motion during active abduction, causing a so-called painful arc. Internal impingement describes an encroachment of the rotator cuff tendons between the humeral head and the glenoid rim. Based on the location of this encroachment, there are two types, anteroposterior and posteroposterior glenoid impingement. Anteroposterior glenoid impingement occurs after deep surface tears of the subscapularis retract, which subsequently becomes trapped between the anteroposterior glenoid rim and the humeral head. Pain is typically provoked in shoulder flexion with internal rotation. Posteroposterior glenoid impingement consists mostly of the encroachment of the supra and infraspinatus tendons between the greater tubercle of the humerus and the posteroposterior rim of the glenoid. Pain is typically provoked in maximal external rotation, horizontal abduction, and a certain amount of abduction. Just imagine an overhead throwing position. Apart from the distinction based on the site of encroachment, shoulder impingement is further classified based on the cause of the problem, dividing it into primary and secondary impingement. In primary impingement, the source of pain and dysfunction is a structural narrowing of the subacromial space occurring due to acromioclavicular arthropathy, due to a type 1 or 3 acromion, which is a flat acromion lacking the natural curvature, or a hooked acromion respectively, or due to swelling of soft tissue within the subacromial space. In secondary impingement, there are no structural abnormalities causing the dysfunction, but rather functional problems occurring in specific positions. It may occur in the subacromial space as well as internally in the glenohumeral joint. So with all this information, you might ask yourself how to correctly identify the underlying pathological mechanism in a patient who presents with impingement symptoms. Coles et al. From the year 2008 have developed an algorithm for clinicians that should assist you in the assessment of impingement patients. Based on the outcomes of different clinical tests, you can narrow down to one of the aforementioned pathological mechanisms: rotator cuff pathology, scapular dyskinesis, shoulder instability, biceps pathology, slap lesions, and glenohumeral internal rotation deficit. Click on the different boxes to get to the respective video where we outline the specifics of each test. You can also click on the link in the description to start a playlist. This was Andreas for PhysioTutors. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to give it a thumbs up, comment, and subscribe if you haven't. Please check out our Facebook page, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.